But we'll have new handouts for you each week, because this subject is extremely important, and it will turn our households around.
Amen.
And it will take us to where we belong. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that you think through my mind, you speak through my mouth, the words of life. I thank you, Lord, for the words of exhortation, edification, and comfort. I thank you, Lord, for the healing word. I thank you, Lord, that it will be all of you and none of me. I choose to be crucified, that you would be glorified, and that your lambs and your sheep would be edified. And I thank you, Lord God, for the rain. I thank you for the rain. I thank you for the rain in every household. I thank you, Lord, for the spirit of healing, glory, and restoration in every household. And I thank you, Lord, that all will see and give you the glory. That there would not be one who would be like those nine who left after their healing and did not give you the glory. But we decree and declare we'll be like that Samaritan that came back to you, giving glory to God, and you made every whit whole. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
For your truth. Your word is truth. And your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. In Jesus' name. Let's go here to Romans chapter 10. Let's stand as we read verses 1 to 17 of Romans chapter 10. Verses 1 to 17 of Romans chapter 10. When you have it, just say amen.
Amen.
Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. Verse 2. For they being ignorant of God's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. Verse 4.
For righteousness is in the law
for Moses describes the righteousness which is of the law, that the man which doth these things shall live by them. Verse 6. Or who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring up Christ again from the dead. Verse 8. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Verse 10. For the scripture says, whosoever believes on him shall not be ashamed. Verse 12. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. 14. And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Verse 16.
But they have not all obeyed the gospel, but I say, Lord, who have we in our reward?
all together, verse 17, so that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Do it again. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word. One more time. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Amen. You may be seated. Now we said that, everyone have notes? Does anyone need notes? And the youngs up here? The reason why we're having these notes is that the walk of faith is an academic walk also. You know, and if you miss the academics of the Word of God, you'll miss probably 85% of your salvation experience that you're supposed to have. You know, it is academic. You know, it's the Word. You read words, right? Words have pictures, right? They give you guidance. They give you direction. So if you do not put yourself in the Word, you can't have the guidance. You can't have the knowledge. You know, you can't have the understanding. And so, you know, it's very important that you worship the Lord, mind, will, emotions, amen, spirit, soul, body. Amen. But the word is very academic. And there's people who love God with all their heart, but have failed in the realm of academics. So they believe as much as they can. But faith comes as you're in the word. It don't come with what you feel. You might feel great right now. By six tonight, you might feel, you know, like you're not even saved, but you are. But if you run off of how you feel, you'll never win the race. You won't even get close. We must be academic. That's just fact. If you don't read your Bible, you're in the back of the bus. With two flat tires. With no spare and no jack. So, you're stuck. So we said that the objective, and this might be for some of you, it's you know, we're going over something you already know. But what I have found that whenever you go over the fundamentals of any, and we're coming to, this is, and some of you might be baseball fans, some of you not be, but we're coming into the final games before the World Series, and usually all the teams that get to this place, they have the fundamentals down. Yeah. They still have pitching coaches. They still have batting coaches. Why? Because the fundamentals bring you into the championship.
My Lord.
So we're going over the fundamentals of faith so that you can make sure that you're walking in faith, because the Bible says this is what we live by. Yes. We live by the Word of God. We live by our faith growing and growing and growing, and over time we look back and we can smile at things that ensnared us. We can smile at things that defeated us, because as our faith grows, our problems become less and less. Our victories become more and more, but most of all, our satisfaction on the inside, our contentment becomes more and more. See, godliness and contentment is great gain.
My Lord.
If you notice, it's just something about human nature. You know, you can get more and still not be content. Right. You can get more and still want more. Yeah. I mean, that's okay as long as it's being guided by the Spirit of God. But godliness and contentment is great gain. Meaning, when the word has filled your belly, it will satisfy you, and you will be able to have a peace and a contentment until you get where you want to go.
Amen. Amen.
So we said that our objective, one of our objectives, is to bring the whole congregation to newfound consecration and dedication. Amen. through an understanding of faith righteousness and the miracles that one can walk in when it's obeyed. If you need a miracle, you can get it. Glory to God. We said number two, to bring deliverance in areas that the enemy has used to stop, hinder, and afflict. And then we said to bring newfound prosperity and blessing to every family. And we said that there's the five elements of faith. We said there's the hearing component. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. That's probably the most important component, is the hearing component. Meaning, because when you're putting yourself in the word of God, you know, the word of God is to be read, and you can read it, you know, to yourself. You can read it out loud. Many believe it was meant to be read out loud, but you know, when you're reading to yourself, you know, it is a type of reading out loud, if you know what I mean. You know, when you're concentrating, you know, when you're focused. And so we said that the hearing component is probably the most important component, because it begins to cause you to have an awareness. Then we said there's the receiving component. And to receive, we said, it means to accept or receive something as being legitimate. When you receive, you say, the word is true. This is truth. This is right. This is legitimate. Amen. It is for me. We said it also means to be open to further listening. Amen. I receive it. Amen. It is right. It is right for me. Amen. This is why God saved me. He saved me to walk in his word. He saved me for purpose and destiny. And I find purpose and destiny in his word. It is a legitimate word. And I'm open to more of the word of God. I'm willing to listen to more of the word of God. Amen. Mark 11:23. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he says. Verse 24, actually, this was receiving is supposed to be Mark 11:24. That's my mistake. Mark 11:24 says, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe you receive them, and you shall have them. Amen. You believe, you receive. Amen. So sometimes I just say, when it comes to things that I'm believing God for, I'll just say throughout the day, I believe that I receive. I believe that I receive. You know, I found my blood pressure wasn't, first my blood sugar wasn't right. And I just started speaking that. And it's been lovely lately. Amen. And I say, my blood pressure. I believe that I received my blood pressure 120 over 80. Amen. Now, some of you younger ones, you ain't got to worry about that right now. But you get older, that's a very good number. That I just say all day long, your pressure, you hear the word of the Lord. Man. 120 over 80. 120 over 80. 120 over 80. I believe I receive. Amen. Amen. Talk to it. Talk to it. The way of faith. Faith is voice activated. Never forget that. Amen. You know, your mouth can remove your mountain. But if you don't open your mountain is not moving. And that takes it takes time for us to learn these things. But you got to understand, faith is voice activated. Amen. You call it a dog, you call it a cat. You know, I used to have this car. It was so cold. You know, I go to start up and I'd be talking to it. I didn't even, come on. come on now. But thank God those days are over now. Amen. But we talk to a lot of things. We don't realize, but we talk to a lot of things. Faith is voice activated. If you don't get the voice down, you'll probably not get what you're believing for down. Amen. Now God is merciful, you know, but as you go on in this thing, He's expecting you to know. Amen. And to believe and to receive and to walk on. Amen. So it says, therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire when you pray, believe you receive them. Amen. And you shall have them. Amen. Receiving. Amen. To accept or receive something as being legitimate and to be open to further listening. Then we said there's the believing element. The believing element. Mark 9:23. Jesus said unto him, if thou can believe, all things are possible to him that believe. Romans 10:10. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Amen. So we said to believe is to commit. Believing is a commitment of the heart. Romans 10:10. With the heart man believes unto righteousness. With the heart man believes unto righteousness. Amen. So believing is a commitment of the heart. It means to commit to trust. Commit your trust to God and what He has said. Commit your trust to God and to what He has said. Believing is a matter of trust. You know you're believing when you're trusting, and with trusting comes a rest. You know, all the anxiety and the worry and all of that, you know, that all of that family, that lets you know you need to trust more. You need to believe. Amen. You need to put yourself in the scriptures until you find your inner man resting. Amen. Now remember, the enemy's having a field day with this anxiety thing. Hear people say it all the time, along with Christians, I'm stressing. All the time you hear, how are you? I'm stressing today. It's very stressful. Well, I mean, if you call it, you really gonna have it. I mean, you don't even gotta call it. You know, it's all over the place. Amen. I looked on the television the other day, Israel getting bombed. Last night it turned on the news, a policeman was shot at the airport the other night, and one killed and one was coming out of the hospital. Last night he was all in tears. He lost his partner. You know, the Bible says in these last and evil days there's going to be wars and rumors of wars, and it's going to be famines and all kinds of floodings. You know, all kinds of things are, you know, warnings of the human experience coming into an end. And then John said, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. And it's, you know, especially when you've been down here for a while, you know, it's like, you know, you're like, you know what, man, what is life without Jesus? You know, what is life without this hope in Christ? You know? And you know, the Bible says the gods of the heathens are devils. You know? They have eyes, but they can't see. They have ears, but they can't hear. You know? And, you know, you study history. Many of the slaughters in history was when the kings and the queens listened to the soothsayers and the, you know, the astrologers and, you know, those that had no covenant with God, you know. And just like the devil, he leads you into a couple battles in success. But the main one, you know, it'll be a prophet lie,
yeah.
You know. And they got slaughtered, many of them. You know, many nations went under because their God was not the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
And the word of God says, if in this life, you know, If we don't have Jesus in this life, you know, we are of all men most miserable. You know, praying, believing God, being in affliction, coming out of affliction, amen, persecuted when you're trying to walk with God. I never forget when I first got born again. Some of you experienced it on the job. I started getting persecuted. Ain't never bothered me on the job, you know? And I was a little man, but you ain't messing with me on the job. I'm coming to get my money. I ain't coming for no static. And I'm trying to do the right thing now, and I got my little verses on. I done wrote down, and on my lunch break, I'm going over my verses. All of a sudden, I'm being, you know, they're persecuting me. You know? You get persecuted for righteousness. You know? But, you know, in this life, you know, we're going to have tribulation. But Jesus said, be of good cheer. I've overcome the world. Yeah. Amen? Yeah. I've overcome. And if I've overcome, you overcome. Amen? Yeah. So the enemy doesn't want you to believe, because all things are possible to those who believe. Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believe. Romans 10:10, for with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Mark 11:23-24, for verily I say unto you, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe you receive them, and you shall have them. Now, in Mark 11:23, you'll see say three times and believe one time. And I heard a man of God say this years ago. He said the Lord told him that the people of God need to say three times as much. Amen. Because we're believers. We believe. Yes. We've been made to believe. But the tongue is it's the Bible says the tongue no man can tame. So let's go over there to James 3 real quickly, because we need to say it. You need to say it. Tell your neighbor you need to say it. Say it.
Say it.
I know we went to church silent. I went to my church coming up. Silence was golden. You could hear a pin drop in that Baptist church. I told my mom, we ain't even real Baptists. You know what I mean? That Baptist church, they be singing it. We had the opera. Oh, I guess they was the uppity black folk. But, you know, we had the operas and the cantatas and everything. But, you know, I'm not against that. But the Word of God says if you're going to walk in faith, you're going to have to be a part of you have to be part of the redeemed that say so. Yeah. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. What that means? That means that faith is voice activated. And if you're going to get around the kingdom of God, if you're going to walk in the promises of God, you're going to have to say it. Now, I tell you all the time, don't cast your pearls before swine. Don't give that which is holy to the dogs. Don't stand up in the midst of the office and, you know, with all these unbelievers around telling them, and I'm the head, not the tail, but I'm the head. I claim I knew how to, you know. You're going to have a rougher day tomorrow. Don't cast your pearls before swine. Some things you just keep to yourself. Amen. And if you're blessed to have a prayer partner, you share it with them. Amen. And pray with people that love you. They don't have to be as spiritual. They just have to love you. Because love covers a multitude of sins. Love is the fulfillment of all the commandments. You can have a babe in Christ that loves you and get more done than with a mature Christian who's judging you every move you make. She ain't even saying Jesus' name. She just said amen. Everybody knows you say in Jesus' name amen. It's better to have somebody who just loves you and going with you Then they got somebody, you know, the Bible says knowledge will puff you up, but love will edify you. Love will always find a way for to be a win-win situation. But knowledge will just puff you up and, you know. James 3, it says, my brethren, be not many masters, knowing we shall receive the greater condemnation. For in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in word, he is a perfect man and able to bridle the whole body. Now, it's talking about the tongue. And I said, faith is voice activated. You're going to have to start saying things you believe you receive. You know, you're going to have to start saying them to yourself throughout the day. Just don't wait till you're at your coffee table or at the kitchen table or laying on your bed. Don't let your devotion just start one time a day. All day long, say of the Lord. All day long, say of the Lord. I believe I received my healing. And talk to your hip, come in line. Come in line. Get out of disobedience. Come in line. Submit to the will of God. I will not be living. That's coming out of me from like a couple months ago. My hip was, I said, loose here, devil. Get your hands off my hip. Come in line with the word of God. Come in line with the word of God. Come in line with the word of God. Hallelujah. Come in line. Pain, get out of my hip. Pain, get out of my body. I'm redeemed from destruction. My life is redeemed from destruction. I've been crowned with loving kindness and tender mercy. The Lord loves me, and he loves me to walk in health. He loves me to walk in strength. Hallelujah. Thank God for health. Thank God for strength. Thank God for increase. He delights in the prosperity. He takes pleasure in the prosperity of his servants. Faith is voice activated. You're going to learn how to say it. And you're going to have to learn to talk to your aches and pain. Amen. Tell your foot to line up with the word. What is all this talking to? It's the way of God. It's the way of God. It's the way of faith. It's the way of the kingdom. Jesus is the King of the kingdom. Amen. And we confess his lordship. And we continue to confess his word and move all the way around the kingdom by way of the word of the King. So speak to your circumstances. Speak over your children. Amen. Amen. Speak about your job. Amen. Is it all? We all getting laid off. We ain't getting laid off. And if we do, we're going somewhere better. Don't let that womp, womp, womp. Don't let that get on you. Oh, we getting laid off. Did you hear we getting laid off? Yeah, we getting laid off. You hear we getting laid off? Oh, y'all all in agreement. Would somebody say we're not going to be laid off? Glory to God. We believe, glory to God. And whatever contracts is needed for this company, whatever is needed, is coming. And if it don't come, we're going somewhere greater. But we're walking in the shalom of God. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Nothing broken, nothing missing. Somebody say, faith is voice activated.
Faith is voice activated.
And it turns your circumstances around. Now, just in case for you quiet people, you don't have to be as loud as me, but you still got to say it. You say it to yourself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm healed by the stripes of Jesus. I'm increasing more and more, me and my children. My children are taught of the Lord, and great is the peace of my children. My children are going in the way of God. Now, if you're going to sit up there and get on the phone with your girlfriends and cry and moan and groan and bellyache, well, you're not going to see it. Verse 3. Behold, we put bits in the horse's mouth that they may obey us, and we turn about their whole body. Behold also the ships, which though they be so great and are driven of furious winds, yet are they turned about with a very small helm, whithersoever the governor listeth. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasts great things, Behold how great a matter a little fire kindles. And the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. So is the tongue among our members, that it defiles the whole body and sets on fire the course of nature and is set on fire of hell. For every kind of beast and of birds and of serpents and of things in the sea is tamed and have been tamed of mankind. But the tongue can no man tame. It is an unruly evil full of deadly poison. Therefore, bless we God. Hallelujah. Even the Father. Hallelujah. And therewith curse we men. Get out of my faith. Which are made after the similitude of God. Now, I said that to say, death and life is in the power of your tongue. And it says in Mark 11:23, therefore I say unto you, whosoever shall say to the mountain, which is your problem, then the word says, the way of faith says, talk to your mountain. Don't talk to God about your mountain. I know some of y'all say, Pastor, I know this. This is all elementary. Oh, blessed is the person that does it. It's easy to say. But when you get to work and they coming against you, when you get in situations that the doctor has spoken over you, I'll never forget when I was down at Johns Hopkins, I know this was the Holy Ghost. When the doctor came and he took that x-ray, and when he told me, he said, young man, you'll never be able to preach for a living. That's it. He said, you might as well. He said, do you have any other thing you can do? First thing I said, I told him, I'm going to dip into my reservoir of healing. Boy, you would have thought I called his mother out. He got so mad with me. He was fine. This old man, too, looked like he's ready to retire. What kind of bedside manner is this? All I told him was I was going to dip into my red. What you say when the problem first arises has everything to do with your finish. Boy, if you get intimidated and go, I wonder if it's my time. It ain't your time. You would know if it's your time. You know when your belly is full and your family is full, amen, and you're ready to go home to be with the Lord. You got too many people. You got too many family members in the snare of the devil right now. You can't go nowhere. God needs every voice in the kingdom at this hour. You don't need to go nowhere. Well, you know, I just can't. You know, it's just too much. Well, overcome it. So it won't be too much. So I don't know. Well, you know, what are you talking about? You need more word. And you need it in your mouth. And faith has two places. I'm going to be redundant with this. In your mouth and in your heart. That's where you got to put the work in. And then you'll see a gradual change. You get the blade, you get the ear, you get the full corn on the ear. Amen? Then we said there's the speaking component. We said to speak means to command, to call, to answer, to agree with God out of your mouth. And then there's the action part. Means to act out, action, to move forward. To act like what you're believing for is true. Amen? Amen? And then we said that James 1:22-24. Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. For if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is likened unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholds himself and goes his way, and straightway forget what manner of man he was. So we said that there's the hearing element component, the receiving component, the believing component, the speaking component, and the acting component. And we said that believing and speaking opens the door to the supernatural. Believing and speaking opens. Now these, I've always called these things, these truths, simplistically profound. They're very simplistic. I've had other preachers confront me on the simplicity. You read those little Reverend Hagin books, those third grade books. But these truths are simplistically profound. Remember, in Jesus' earthly ministry, he was preaching to primarily, you know, everyday people. Most of them never went to school. They were farmers. You know, they were landowners. They were in the business of agriculture. And he taught in parables. He taught very simplistically to them. And so, saying what God says about you, speaking to your problem, not talking to God about them, speak to your problem. Why? Because you have authority. Luke chapter 10, verse 9. Jesus is talking to his disciples. He says, "And heal the sick that are therein, and say to them, the kingdom of God is come nigh unto you." Luke chapter 10, 17 to 21. Remember, you have authority. "And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding, in this rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven." Amen? So remember, you know, that you have authority. And, it, you know, God says, just say my word and I will back you. That's what he's saying. He's not saying that you and of yourself can remove this cancer, that you and of yourself can cause, you know, one of your family members that's, you know, way, way, way out there that can come in. But he's saying that you speak my word. You speak the word only. Remember, the centurion told Jesus, "Speak a word only, my servant will be healed." That's what the Father is saying to us. Say my word and my spirit will back you. Just keep saying it. When you're weary, say it. When you're happy, say it. When you're sad, say it. When the devil's trying to confuse you, say it. I'm healed. I got peace in my mind. I got joy in my heart. And I got strength in my body. And I'm going forward. Let's say this. Say, I got peace in my mind. I got joy in my heart. I got strength in my body. And I'm going forward. I'm walking in purpose. I'm walking in destiny. I receive all God has for me. It's not too late.
It's not too late.
Amen. God used the man. I don't even know if he's born again. I believe for his salvation. One of my neighbors. We had a little tragedy happen in the neighborhood, and one of my neighbors came and told me about it. And it was a couple months late, and I said, "You think I should go over there?" And he looks at me and says, "Never too late, Ken. Never too late." Okay. Take the word of the heathen today. Never too late. Never too late to get your money. Never too late to go forward. Never too late to get a new house. Why are you talking about that? You need to move on up.
Yes.
You get stuck in a place, you get stuck. You just don't get stuck in one place. That place gets you stuck in other places.
Yes.
You need to move. So, you know, I don't need no new mortgage. How you know you're going to have a mortgage?
Yes.
God can give you a debt-free place.
Yes.
I said, God can give you a debt-free place. God can open it up and make you an example. Jeremiah 32:27. Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? Jeremiah 33:3. Call unto me and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not.
Thank you, Lord.
It's possible. It's possible. You know, it says over there in the book of Isaiah, you can buy without money and without price.
Amen.
Woo! Hallelujah. You can move on up and not use your dime. Hallelujah. I had an experience happen to me. I'll never forget. We had a doctor, DeShields. I don't know if you remember them, some of you, but I was, they had a Christmas party up in Avondale, and my mom was up there, it was during the Christmas season, and the Spirit of God said, you're going to move into this house. I said, I don't move into my member's house. I'll make a way for them. So I was living in this complex, and I guess I was tired of them and they was tired of me. So I told them I'll be moving out by the fall. And the fall came and I forgot that I had got smart with the front office. So the front office called me and said, Mr. Gaines, your place has been leased out. And we're expecting you to be gone by this time in the fall. I said, well, what you talking about, Willis? So, Dr. DeShields had been telling me, come on, move it. We're going to move. We're moving our practice. Come on up in here. I kept saying no. I'm the man of faith. I don't need to move into my member's house. I called her back, hey, is that offer still available? That offer still available?
Yeah.
What happened? I forgot, I told the front office I was moving out in the fall. And they took my word up on it and said, yeah, you will be moving out. But I said that to say, I'm in this 2 master bedroom, 5 or 6 bedroom house, you know, and I was paying something so ridiculous, ridiculously low. And God had me up there, and then after a season, you know, I went on and brought a house up in the Hocassin, but I just said, you know, God can move you around. He can move you into a house. He can upgrade you without you putting out a dime. Declare it. But you're going to have to start opening your sanctified mouth and declaring your favor. And at that time, I said favor every day. I wake up, favor, 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 favor. I'm God's favorite son, and the favor of God is on my life. Everywhere I go, the favor of God is meeting up with me. Folks who don't even like me favor me. Hallelujah! Because God is a God of favor, and he has crowned me with loving kindness and tender mercy. He satisfies my mouth with good things. My youth is renewed like the eagle. Faith is voice activated. believing and receiving opens the door to the supernatural. Walk in your authority. When you have the authority, you have authority over your circumstances. Take action and give God praise, because there's nothing to our friend. We just read those verses. Now, let's close with this. Number three. There's a fight to get the faith, your faith, into the real you. Remember, your brain is not the real you. Your brain is your organ. Your spirit or your heart is the real you. And there's a fight to get it from your brain into your heart. This is where many people go wrong. Because they know the scriptures, they can quote the scriptures, they feel like they have it in their heart. Your brain and your heart are two different things. One's an organ, one's the real you. That's why David said, "Thy word have I hid in my heart." You got to get the word in your heart. The only word that the devil will respond to, the only word that will make him back off, is the word that's in your heart. Because you're a spirit and he's a spirit. And when God's word comes out of your spirit, it attacks him. The word on the devil is like a two-edged sword on your flesh. When you tell the devil, "Get off! Get off my body! I believe I received my healing. By God's stripes I was healed." Body, line up with the word of God. Now you're wheeling your sword around. You're wheeling your sword around. Some of you got the word, but you won't release it. You got the word, but your mouth is tied up. You let the devil give you a gag order. The devil done set you in the chair and gagged your mouth. I know the verse. I can't get it out. You better say it. You got to say it. See, Pastor, I done heard this. I done heard all... I didn't forget, Pastor Mike knows this lady wanted a job over in Jersey, and she said, I work with Dr. Price. She named all the faith ministries, and so I said, okay, all right. She's giving a testimony when she worked with all these people, and but you can almost locate people by what they say. No faith being released. You can read the Bible all day, but if you don't say something, that faith is not released. You have authority. And you've got to learn how to say it. This is learned behavior. Well, that's too simplistic for me. That's just too elementary for me. Well, Jesus spoke to the fig tree. He spoke to the rain. He spoke to the water. He spoke to the sea. You know, he spoke to the blind man. He spoke, well, you know, the servant is not greater than the master. I said the servant's not greater than the master. All through the Gospels, you see Jesus speaking a thing. And then he would tell folk, according to your faith, great is your faith. According to your faith, great is your faith. And she said, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I will be whole. And she said, if I just touch the hem of his garment, and she's getting stronger with each word, if I can touch the hem of his garment, if I can touch the hem of his garment, if I can touch the hem of his garment, and she got strong enough to press through the crowd and touched his garment, and she was immediately made whole. Speaking your faith will strengthen you. It will give you an inward confidence. Call that money in. I got to tell everybody. Call it in for yourself. Hallelujah. We got 4 months at the end of the money this month. See, Pastor's at the end of the money. It didn't happen. Keep saying it. I got 4 months. I got more money at the end of the month. So what it take you 6 months? Wait till that increase comes. And you lie down. Ooh, don't know nobody but the love. Hallelujah. Woo. Oh, I tell you, when the Bible says when the answer comes, it's a tree of life. There's a fight to get in the real you. 1 Timothy 6:12, fight the good fight of faith. We close with this. Man is a tripartite being. With the body, he contacts the three-dimensional world around him. With his soul, he is able to contact the intellectual realm. And with the spirit, he contacts the spirit world. Salvation directly impacts the spiritual part of man, leaving the body and the soul to be developed after salvation. That's why you got to be careful who you say is saved and not saved. Because salvation contacts the spirit man first. I believe there are going to be people in heaven we never thought was going to be there. Then there are going to be people in heaven we looking for, still looking for. And then we're going to be glad we're there ourselves. The testimony of Scripture is just that. The spirit of man is born again, and the natural soulish part of man has to be disciplined in accordance to the word of God. Amen? But now remember this. You got to get the word in your heart. That's why we have the plow. Tuesdays at 1, Wednesdays at 6, Thursdays at 1, Friday at 1. We just read the word and then pray. So what are you doing that? I read the Bible, but you can't overread. You can't do too much reading. And a lot of folk in trouble still not reading. Faith comes by hearing. You know, and all of you, you know, most of you know this. The mystery of faith is you just stay with at it, and one day you believe like never before. It's amazing. I've been saying the same thing. I've been reading the same thing. But today, I know I'm healed. Today, I'm moving all around. I'm willing to do whatever I need to do, because today, that thing bore witness with my spirit. It struck my spirit. It is out of my brain. It is in my heart. And I declare it is a word of faith. And I know that I know. You can't talk me out. You can't beat it out of me. That's where you got to go. That's where you got to go. You got to get it from your brain into your heart. And then you walk with it. Then you can have it. Amen? Then you can have it. Amen. You'll have whatsoever you've been saying. Now for some of you moms, I'm closing with this. For some of you moms, my mom was a wonderful woman of God, a wonderful intercessor. But because of my behavior patterns, she would say, he just bad. Now what is it? Is he saved? Is he healed? Is he delivered? Or is he bad? Which one? You can't be all of them. I hear on the phone, he came out, you know, I gave a curfew, he didn't keep the curfew, he didn't, some old degenerates dropped him off in the car. Smell him when he get in the house, smell him all the way upstairs. Well, you can't call your son bad, you can't call him all kinds of negative names and then claim him. Hold fast your confession. He's saved and he's walking with Jesus. Well, that don't look saved to me. He looked high and burnt out. The boy looked very confused and disorientated. Last thing he looked is saved and walking with Jesus. Well, the Bible says part of this voice activation is calling the thing that be not as though it happened yesterday. I'm just broke, Pastor. I don't want to lie about it. I can't be talking about all money I got. That's a lie. I'm broke. My bank account is negative. My checks is bouncing all over the place. Well, don't write bad checks. You can go to jail for that. But begin to call the thing that be not, as though it's already happened. Come on, lift your hands up. Say this with me. Father, I thank you that your word is alive. And it's alive in my heart. It's past my brain. It's in my spirit. It's in the real me. And I thank you, Father. It's a word of faith. And I'm going to declare it all the days of my life. You've forgiven all my iniquities. You've healed me from every sickness and disease. You've redeemed my life from destruction. I'm redeemed from fatal car accidents. I'm redeemed from fatal plane accidents. I'm redeemed from heart attacks, strokes, and sudden death. My life is redeemed from destruction. The favor of God is on my life. Pressed down, shaken together, running over. Favor! 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 I say it until I see it. I believe it and I receive it. The favor of God is on me and mine until Jesus comes. I am not afraid. I am not afraid. I speak to that spirit of fear. Get out of my life. Get out of my mind. Get out of my life. I have the spirit of power. I have the spirit of agape love. Unconditional love has filled my heart. And I have a sound mind. I see things correctly. And I walk therein. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. It's getting better. It's getting easier. It's getting lighter. I'm getting stronger. I said it's getting better. For my children. For my spouse. For my whole family. It's getting easier. And it's getting lighter. We are strong in the Lord. We are strong in the word. We are strong in confession. We are strong in doing. We are strong. And we're living long in the power of the Holy Ghost. Thank God. It is well. It is well. It is well. It is well. Jesus is Lord. And his word is working mightily in me. Come on, somebody give God some.